Good morning everyone. Here we have the topic energy and its forms, and in this class we will know about kinetic energy, that is the energy caused by a moving object. This is the definition. The energy caused by a body due to its state of motion. That means the energy which is caused because of the motion of the object is kinetic energy. We can take some of the example, like when the bullet is fired from a gun, then the bullet comes in motion, then the bullet has kinetic energy. When a car is moving on a road, that means the car is in motion, so the car has kinetic energy. Suppose we leave the marker from the side, then it starts its motion toward the ground, so this also has a kinetic energy. Now we can take an example here for the expression for the kinetic energy K. Suppose this one is the object moving with velocity v. That means initially it is moving with velocity v, that means it is in motion. So as it is in motion, it has a kinetic energy. And suppose we can consider here the kinetic energy as the value k. Suppose it has the kinetic energy k. Now, as we all know that the amount of energy a body has is equal to the amount of work that the body is capable to do. So that means whenever this body is in motion, it has total kinetic energy K. This K is the magnitude of total kinetic energy of the body have. So K is the total kinetic energy of the body. Now, because of this energy, it is capable of doing work. So what is the quantity of work? What is the magnitude of work? This is equal to the energy of the body. That means this object can do this amount of work, which is exactly equal to the amount of energy the body has. Now suppose, to find out this K, we have to find out this work done. That means what is the amount of work that the body can do? That is, we have to find out. So for this, we applied a force against the motion of the object. See, this gives the direction of application of force against the motion of the object, and this slow down the object. So as the object slow down and comes to rest, see here, we have the second condition. When force is applied, the object V equal to 0, the object comes at rest. So here, what is the value of kinetic energy? Then you all can say that is here the kinetic energy is, this kinetic energy is 0. So during this, the total kinetic energy, the total amount of kinetic energy of the object is utilized, and after that, the kinetic energy becomes 0 when it comes to rest. So that means during this, whatever the work done is exactly equal to, whatever the work done on the body or by the body is exactly equal to the kinetic energy of the body. So what is the work done? That's why we have to find out for this value of K, we have to find out this value of W. And you all know that this is the kinetic energy and this is the work done. And you all know that whenever the work done, work is done, that means there is a measurement of work done, which is equal to F into displacement. So here, let me suppose this one is the displacement from this point to this point. This gives the displacement, and this is the direction of displacement. So here, see, the direction of force is opposite to the direction of displacement. That means it is negative work done. As work done is a scalar quantity, so that's why we won't take care of any negative sign. So that's why the K equal to, that means the kinetic energy equal to this W. See, here it is better if this work done, and this is equal to this force into this displacement. So now we have, see, force into displacement is the kinetic energy. So we have to find out the value of force. So for F, we use the second law of motion, and from the second law of motion, you can see this force equal to mass into acceleration. We have considered the mass of the body as M. Suppose we consider the mass of the body is M. Now, what is the acceleration here? Suppose we consider A is the acceleration. Here, A is the acceleration being caused due to this force, and this acceleration is taken as minus A. Why? Because this is against the motion, that means there is a retardation. That means as the body is slowing down, so that means the acceleration is negative. The acceleration is for decreasing the velocity, that's why we have taken minus A here for the acceleration. So here we have F into minus A. So F into minus A, so this one can be F equal to minus M A, and this is what we have for force. So here we can replace for force, this one will be minus M A. Just now, what is the value of S? Now we go to the equations of motion. the second equation of, sorry, the third equation of motion, that is, see, this is the third equation of motion, 2as equal to v square minus u square. Here you all know that a is negative, so this one will become minus 2as. This s we have to find out for this s, okay? Here, this v, which is the final velocity, which is equal to 0. See, final velocity equal to 0. Now, what is the initial velocity? Initial velocity is v. Here, this is the initial velocity. So, this will become v square. So, finally, we will get what? 2as equal to minus v square. This minus minus cancel. So, s equal to what? V square by 2a. So, this is what we get for the displacement. So, here we can multiply with v square by 2a. So, this one gives the kinetic energy. Let's see. See, after putting the value, we will get here k equal to 1 by 2 m v square. See, 1 by 2 m v square. Here we won't take the minus sign. This is only because work done is this color one k. And you all know that this work done is negative work done. So, that's why the magnitude of this kinetic energy is equal to half m v square. So, this is the final expression for kinetic energy. From this expression, we can say that k is directly proportional to m. That means if m is increases, then k also increases. How it is increases? If m becomes 3 times, then k also becomes 3 times. If m becomes 5 times, then k, that means kinetic energy also becomes 5 times. Now see how the kinetic energy varies with the velocity. From this expression, you can easily say that this k is directly varying with the v square. That means, see this, if v becomes 3 times, then kinetic energy becomes 9 times, the square of 3. If v becomes 5 times, then kinetic energy becomes 25 times, the square of 5. So, this is how the kinetic energy varies with mass and velocity. Now, we will know how kinetic energy k is related with the momentum, that is p. You all know that if any object is in motion, then it have momentum. That means the product of mass and mass and velocity is momentum of the body when it is in motion. See, it is also from the second law of motion that p equal to mass into velocity. So here this v equal to p by m. So here we can substitute this value of v here for k. So we have k equal to 1 by 2 m v square, which becomes 1 by 2 m into what? P by m whole square in the place of v. So this will become k equal to p square by 2 m, and this is the relation of momentum with the kinetic energy. See, after having this expression for k with momentum, if momentum is constant, then k is inversely proportional to mass. That means if mass becomes 2 times when p is constant, and if mass becomes 2 times, then the kinetic energy becomes half, 1 by 2 times. But when we keep the mass of the object constant, then how the kinetic energy relate with p, that is momentum? So it is directly proportional to p square. That means here, when the mass is constant, then, and p is variable, then kinetic energy, see, if we increase the value of p 2 times, if we increase the value of p 2 times, then the kinetic energy become 4 times. If we increase the value of p 3 times, then the kinetic energy become square of 3, that is 9 times. So this is how the kinetic energy relate to the momentum. This is work energy theorem. Here we find out what is the difference in kinetic energy when the same object is increased with its velocity or decreased with its velocity. Suppose we have considered here an object of mass m, and it is moving initially with the speed, with the velocity u here. So that means the mass, the kinetic energy, as mass is given m, so the kinetic energy becomes, as you all know, it becomes 1 by 2 mass into velocity square. Here velocity is u. So this one is the kinetic energy, I can say this one is initial kinetic energy. ki, that means initial kinetic energy. Now the final, as the force is applied here, that means it increases the velocity, and after some time here the object gain the velocity v. Now if it is increase or decrease, no matters, but there is a difference in kinetic energy. Now whatever the kinetic energy, kf becomes 1 by 2 the mass and the velocity square. So this one is the final kinetic energy of the object. So what is the difference here? You can see kf minus kf is the difference. Sorry, kf minus kf. This is the difference in kinetic energy. Now, as we all know that during this, there is a work done. See, if force is applied and this force causes an acceleration or even deceleration. So this force causes an acceleration, and this is the displacement s. So here this force equal to mass into acceleration, as you all know. And for this value of s, we again use the third equation of motion. That means 2as equal to v square minus c square. So here we can get s equal to v square minus c square by 2a. So these are the two values of s and f and s. Here we have to calculate the work done. This work done is equal to force into s displacement. This one is actually the increase in energy or decrease in energy. Even I can say increase or decrease in energy. Yes, all you can understand. Why? Because whenever the force is applied, a amount of energy is given to the body to increase its energy, or some amount of energy released by the body to decrease its energy. So here we consider that the change of energy is actually the work done on the body or work done by the body. So here we have the work done, force into displacement. So this is the change in kinetic energy. Here the change can be represented as delta k. Delta k, that means change in kinetic energy, which is actually the work done here. And this work done equal to force, we have force m a, and into here we have v square minus c square by 2. So 2a is 2a. This one is 2a. See this one, the work done is equal to half m v square minus half m u square, and this work done becomes c here. This one is kf, final kinetic energy, and this one minus initial kinetic energy. So this is actually the difference in kinetic energy. So this is what the work energy theorem. So what we found here, if any work is done on a moving body, then the work done is equal to the increase or decrease in kinetic energy of the body. See, work is done on the body and it is equal to the difference in kinetic energy. See, here if we get minus k, so that means the work done is negative and the kinetic energy decreases. And if we get plus k, that means the work done is positive, like that, and this increases the kinetic energy. See, those are the forms of kinetic energy. As you all know, kinetic energy is the energy causes due to the motion of the object. And motion is of different types. We all know about translational motion, rotational motion, vibrational motion. So if a body is in translational motion, then we say that the body has translational kinetic energy. That means we can consider any linear motion, like a car is moving on a straight line, a body is dropped from a height, so that means it is again along the straight line motion. So these are, we say that those have translational kinetic energy. Then in the same way we can say that what is rotational kinetic energy. If a body rotates like the earth rotates, so the earth has rotational kinetic energy. Vibrational kinetic energy, that means if a body vibrates, if a body is in vibrational motion, like if we stretch a rubber band and pull the middle, then it starts to vibrate. So this has vibrational kinetic energy because it is in vibrational motion. So these are the forms of kinetic energy. Here we have the other forms of energy. First is solar energy. Solar energy is the energy radiated out by the sun. This energy cannot be used directly. So that's why there are some devices to store the solar energy for further use. Those devices like solar furnace, solar cell, solar panel, solar cooker. The solar panel is mostly used for the lighting purpose. You have seen those solar panels. In solar panel, there is a metal plate with black surface. This black surface absorbs the sun's radiation and use it for lighting purpose. Solar cell store the energy and convert the solar energy into electrical energy. This is also used for the lighting purpose. Solar furnace used for the generation of electricity. In solar furnace, a big parabolic curved mirror is placed to focus all the sun rays in a particular area, and here when the sun rays reflected to the particular area, it increases the temperature of the area, and when water is kept on that area, then water changes to steam, and this steam is run through the pipes and used for rotating the turbines, and this generates the electricity. The second one is heat energy, which is also called radiant energy. This heat energy generates when something burns. That means when something is burning, the heat is causes the heat energy. Something like when wood, when the burning of wood, the burning of charcoal, those are produces the heat energy. Now light energy is the energy caused by the light, like when the natural source of light energy is sun. When bulb glows, when candle glows, those gives the light energy, as well as those also give the heat energy. Now fourth one is chemical energy. Chemical energy is the energy stored in a fuel, like when the candle burns. Why the candle burns? Because the candle is made up of a chemical, and this chemical has chemical energy. Why the fuel burns? Why petrol burns? Because petrol has a chemical energy in it, and when it is burned, it releases heat energy and also light energy. Hydro energy, by the name, you can easily understand that the running water has energy. Running water has a kinetic energy. Running water means water is in motion, so it has energy. It is called hydro energy. It is mostly used for the electricity generation purpose. Now sixth one is electrical energy. Electrical energy, we can't go directly to the electrical energy. First we have to know about the charged particle like electron and proton. And we all know that such a charged particle have the property of attraction and repulsion. So those can do work. So the motion of the charged particle causes the energy, which is called the electrical energy. The fan, the electrical appliance runs on the electrical energy. Seventh point is nuclear energy. Nuclear energy is the energy released due to loss in mass during the nuclear reaction, like nuclear fission and nuclear fusion. Nuclear fission means when the heavy nuclei break down into smaller nuclei. This is called nuclear fission. So during this, a mass is lost, and this loss of mass causes energy, and this energy is called nuclear energy. This nuclear fission is used in atomic bombing purpose. Now the second one is nuclear fusion. Nuclear fusion means when the lighter nuclei group together and forms a heavier nucleus. And this is the source of energy in the sun, nuclear fusion. In the sun, the source of energy is the nuclear reaction, that is nuclear fusion. So there is also some loss in mass, and this causes the energy, use energy actually, and this is called nuclear energy. Some in atomic reactors, this nuclear energy is also called atomic energy. In some nuclear reactor, atomic reactor, this kind of like nuclear fusion or reactions are performed for the generation of electricity and for the destructive purpose, as you know, atomic bombing. Here the fourth to eighth one is geothermal energy. Geothermal energy, as by name, geo means the earth. Inside the earth, there are some mountain rocks at high temperature. So those are sometimes released out. So this also releases some energy, and this energy can be utilized in different purposes. So this is called geothermal energy. See, about the geothermal energy, what I have studied, that in some places there is an opening on the surface of the earth, and from this opening a high temperature steam comes out, and this running steam can be utilized to rotate the turbines for the generation of electricity. So in this way geothermal energy can utilize. And the ninth one is wind energy. All you know about wind energy, the blowing wind causes the rotation of the windmills, and this causes the electricity. Here sound energy, as you all know, the sound is caused by the vibration, and vibration is a type of motion, and this causes vibrational energy. You all know about forms of kinetic energy, vibrational kinetic energy. So as vibration produces sound, so sound is also a form of energy. The 11th one is magnetic energy. As you know that the poles of the magnet have potential energy, and this energy is called magnetic energy. Now the 12th one is mechanical energy, that is kinetic energy and potential energy, as you know about this. This is the conversion of energy from one form to another form. First you consider from potential energy to kinetic energy. For this we can consider an object placed at a height. Suppose an object is placed at a height and suddenly it starts to fall down. Initially it has potential energy, and when it started to fall down, it starts its motion, and the potential energy is converted to the kinetic energy. Whenever it is in motion, it has the kinetic energy, and whenever it is at rest at the top, it has potential energy. So during this, potential energy changes to kinetic energy. So now how the kinetic energy is changing into potential energy? We have taken the example of spring. When we push the spring, that means our hand has kinetic energy, and because of the motion of the hand we push the spring. So this kinetic energy transferred to the spring, and this kinetic energy is converted to potential energy of the spring. So this is how the kinetic energy converted into potential energy. Now see how mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. So we can take the example of electric generator, where the motion of the armature causes the electrical energy, and this electrical energy is utilized for the lighting purpose and different other purposes. So this is actually the mechanical work done by the armature of the generator. That means the rotator is actually caused, the rotator is actually have a mechanical energy, and this mechanical energy is finally converted into electrical energy and stored in the generator, or it can be utilized for the lighting purpose and other electrical purpose in the home. Now how electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy? So it is more simple. We can say that the electrical energy, we can use the electrical energy to rotate the fan. So the fan, if the fan is rotating, so the rotation of the fan is called is a mechanical work. So here the electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy. See how the electrical energy is converted into heat.